Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick in the Philippines. Yeah, I didn't put my little self in the corner of this thing, my little picture in the corner, so it would load faster, because the internet's, it's been slow. Had lots of rain. Anyway, this is in the attic of the orphanage, and it's separated from the kids by the ceiling of the house, but it's honeybees, and they're already making honey, and it's only been, what, 2 months maybe since the orphanage was finished? Maybe 1 month, 2 months, and we already have honeybees. And then, you know, biblically speaking, you know, honey is a blessing. Honey is good. It's a blessing. And so we're going to leave it there, and it's not bothering anybody, and it will also help increase the production of the fruit that we have, and vegetables are growing there at the orphanage. So Pastor, we call him Issue, or Rinyello, can't pronounce it right, he went up there and took a picture of it for us. And anyway, there's the honeybees and the honey. And he has a relative, Pastor Issue, the house dad, has a relative who will harvest it. Every February it will be harvested. And so it's pretty cool. And that's several pictures of it there. Okay, now this is what I did was, is I went to the orphanage yesterday. That would be Thursday. I guess that's the 17th. And I did a blessing, and that's the child of Rowena, the house mom, Pastora, or Sister Rowena. That's their daughter, Laura. And I'm praying for her because it was her birthday on the 10th, and I was not around. I was up there in Manila. So anyway, we did a prayer for her and like a blessing, and she's 1 year old. Sorry about that. I didn't check the photos yet. That's still another one of my wife's relatives, and I'm praying for her. Her name is Grace, and praying for a blessing for her. That's me with Grace again. I didn't go through these photos. Sorry, guys. Of course, that's Joni. That's Joni, the biggest character there. Her and Earl are very much characters there. That's John Ray. He's pretty shy. John Ray is a shy boy, and Earl is the one that's looking for attention in Joni. Still me with John Ray. Okay. This is Love, or Lovely. She's the one whose mom has cancer. She's the last one we added there, and she's liking it there and doing good in school. There's Earl. And he's being a little silly. That's why I was laughing, but I prayed for them. There's still Earl. And this John Ray actually has an older sister. This is her, and she's 16. And she just came there. Now, she's a little bit older, but what she's doing is she's staying there, and she's, you know, she wanted to be with her brother. And then also she's like the nanny taking care of the Laura, the one-year-old daughter of the house mom and dad, because they need help, you know. They got the five orphans there, and then their own daughter, and so this girl is going to stay there, and then she can be with her brother and try to help take care of Laura. And then she also has been doing the laundry, and so, you know, I'm told them that we're going to make sure that we can give her a little pay for doing that, and really a sponsor for her, even though she's already 16. But I'm looking if anybody wants to sponsor her. They call her Ann, or Ann is her name. And she's 16, and she's almost a really full-blooded native, basically. And that's why she's so short. Usually the people from the mountains, you know, because of their diet and all that, and then, you know, genetic, this more full-blooded native people, they're really short. So she's not even, I don't know, 4 foot something. And she's a little bitty girl. And, you know, she's been through the fifth grade, and that's pretty standard in most of the remote areas of the Philippines, especially here in the southern part. And that's me praying for her. Now, that is the uncle of Pastor Issue, and he's never been married, and he's there visiting, and he's helping them doing the, I bought a bunch of gravel. We bought a bunch of gravel because there's lots of flooding around the houses, as I mentioned in an earlier video. And, you know, the mosquito problem is bad there. You know, of course, as you know, too, of course, Joshua died of dengue fever, which comes from mosquitoes. And we don't want none of the orphans to get dengue fever and die. And there's a dengue fever outbreak all around there. So we're praying about that. And then we got screens in the windows. And we're trying to get some more better drainage on the land, because there's lots of swampy areas in the Philippines. They don't have anything like that in the Philippines. You know, they're not into those kind of things. Cleaning up and stuff, you know, and draining off the water and all that. So we had to do it then. There we're praying. And my wife, Jessa, she's helping me pray for the adults. And there's all the orphans there. And that's my father-in-law. And that's the baby Laura there with Ann. So let's see. And that's still praying with him. Now that's a pastor issue. As we call him, that's his nickname, and there we're praying for him. He has his relatives who stop by and visiting, and some of them are pretty bad, pretty wild, and so we're praying for him to be able to handle them and deal with them and make sure there's no problems. It's just, you know, daily life in the world, especially in a country like the Philippines. And still got multiple pictures. Now, see, there's a little better lighting on that one. I don't know why the other ones, they don't have a good lighting. Okay, now there's the house mom, the wife of Pastor Issued, Rowena. We call her here in the Philippines. They're known as a pastora or Sister Rowena. We're praying for her. And the Lord, I wish my wife wanted to make an audio tape of this, because, or, you know, an audio video of this, because I had a word for everybody. You know, whenever I keep, when I do these prayovers, whenever I pray for people in churches, if we have time, or in a group like this, you know, the Lord will usually give me a word for everybody. You know, that's my ministry. And so I have a word of knowledge for these guys, all of them, different things. And I wish I could have recorded it, because it's pretty, it can be interesting and instructional and educational. And anyway, there I am, still praying. It's still the same. My brother-in-law. And he's helping around there with the landscaping also. And him and his wife, was my sister-in-law and her husband, they're Christians, and they're going to be, you know, when we're going to, by the grace of God, expand, you know, to the other house. They're in the other house, and they will also, by the grace of God, we're going to have 10 kids with them and 10 kids there with Rowena and Issued. And then Rowena and Issued are the spirit, will be the spiritual leaders of all, both houses, you know, for daily devotionals and all that. And then, but these guys will be the house mom and dad in the other house. But all under, really, the leader there is Rowena and Issue, as far as the, being the pastor and the spiritual part of it and devotional. My sister-in-law and her husband, that's him, Ramel, and he's the driver there. He's going to be, you know, he has a license, professional license. He's a professional driver and a welder. So he can do lots of things around there to maintain the houses, to drive the kids to school and all this kind of stuff. We have motorcycles now, but I'm looking that we'll have a vehicle later on. We have the 20 kids. We'll have a car or whatever, a truck or whatever. And he handles all that kind of the labor stuff, you know, and a house dad. So I'm just praying for him to be anointed, and he's doing good. He's growing in his relationship with the Lord. You know, it's not just about the orphans. It's also about, you know, the discipleship and development of the staff, too. And me and you guys who have donated and you guys who have prayed. I mean, we're all things work together for the good of those who love God, who are called according to his purposes. So we're all being developed and grown in this situation. Like my wife, you know, she's being developed and grown because, you know, her son died. And, you know, then she's working with somebody else's kids, you know, and it's all part of her growth and development, just like mine also. Okay, now that's my sister-in-law, Mary Tess, they call her. Mary is her name. And I'm praying for her, and I gave a word for her. That's my father-in-law, praying with him, give him a word from the Lord also. And, okay, this is some of the gravel that we put outside, that we got loads of gravel to spread out. Some of it's already spread out. They call it mountain mix. It actually came from them. Side of a mountain they dug out. There's a chicken with the baby chicks there. We have lots of chickens and growing more and more. And I think we have about 30 young chickens, one batch, and then they've been released. Now the moms are having another batch. Sorry I didn't have these pictures set up in advance because I've been so busy. This is the outside where they're cooking, and we're going to build a wooden with a screen cheap structure. It costs about a couple $100. It's like an outside kitchen slash heating area when it's hot on the back of the house. Okay, there's the bathrooms, the showers. We still haven't gotten that cement smoothed on here. We're going to get that done. I already told them that this is really not up to the standard that I'd like to have there. So I'm going to get them to fix this up a little bit better. But it's the boys and the girls, you know, it's a shower combination toilet there in behind the house. You know, and this is my brother-in-law's got his redneck chair out there with some coconuts. And I took a picture of it because he's just sitting in the middle of this big rock pile there. I thought it was kind of funny. And that's some more rocks. And what they're using is this thing here. They don't have a wheelbarrow. They're using this, you know, two men carry thing. And it's got a screen in the middle. And then they're putting the rocks on there. And then they're carrying it by hand, you know, spreading it out. There's the kids on their bikes. I thought I'd get some of them. There's our turkey that we have. We have a turkey, and it's got two or four eggs, I think, that we've got there. There's the basketball hoop. It's up. No net on there yet. We've got to get a net. And all the coconut trees have this. This is to keep rats from climbing up and destroying the coconuts, just if you're FYI there. And this here is where the people climb. People that climb the coconut trees, they make these notches in it so they can climb up there and harvest the coconuts. And I just took some pictures. This is a guava. We have lots of guava trees. This is lemoncito or calamansi. It's a lemon, but it's a small version of one. There's Matthew is just crying because he don't want to do something if you can hear him. This is a mango tree. It hasn't got any fruit on it yet, but it's a mango tree there. Just took a picture of it. Some people had asked me about the pictures of the different fruit. There's the coconuts. You can see it. I zoomed in on it. And see if you can just see. Look how high up these coconut trees are. I zoomed in on this here. Now I'm back down. And they're probably, I don't know, 100 feet higher, whatever. They're way up there. Huge, high trees. And then there we have several different ones. I think we have about 12 or 14 coconut trees just on our land. Those are bananas that are getting there in ripeness. Not completely ripe. There's a ton of different kinds of bananas in the Philippines. Some you got to cook. Some you can eat straight, like in the States. And all different kinds. There's got to be 100 different kinds of bananas in the Philippines. There's some more right there. It's a bunch of bananas. Okay, there's the baby chicks. I got a better shot of them. Okay, and there's Renillo. He had his test at school, so he was late coming home. And then I prayed with Renillo to his sponsor. There he is. We still haven't put down the tiles. These are the tiles here behind, but we haven't put them down yet. They didn't calculate the cost of the labor, so I had to give him some more money when I was there to get the carpenter. We have a carpenter, a master carpenter, and then, of course, my brother-in-law will be his laborer, his assistant, so we're going to save on the labor of that. Anyway, so that's Renillo. And anyway, this is them out there. They're doing the dishes, not the laundry, but the same way they do the dishes, I wanted to show you, you know, what they do. You know, in the Philippines, nobody has really a washing machine. Everybody does their laundry by hand. This is the dishes, though. They weren't doing the laundry when I was there, but people, you know, almost 100% of the people in the Philippines do their laundry by hand. You know, and I pray that someone would be considering helping this young girl. She's only 16, and, you know, they don't have a mom. And it's John Ray's older sister, Ann. And, you know, maybe she'd like to go back to school or something. I'm going to help her out to do something. She's a hard-working girl. And, you know, she just hasn't had any opportunities. So I ask you to pray about that, anyone that would consider helping her. Okay, that's the end of my video. I better cut it off. I'm running out of time. God bless. See you soon.